Ladies and gentlemen, we're here at the FedEx Open Belmont course in Richmond, Virginia for our tried and true video. You know it's coming, ladies and gents. What's in my bag?
We saw the comments, we heard what you wanted, and we're here to give it to you. So,
the people have spoken, and we will deliver. Let's get right into it. Accessory bag. Let's see what we got. iPhone SE. I'm a man of simple taste, and I'm 5 years behind.
Well, might as well start one for one. I've got a shell for my accessory bag, thanks to old Babolat. iPhone 8, tasteful, but still a couple years behind. Keys for my Chevy Cruze. And a wallet. Yes, I still have a wallet.
Moving on. The old folder. That's right, folks, we're following this to a T. Look at our previous video to see our game plan on how we're gonna go from chumps to 4.5. It's all delineated in this folder.
Let's pop open my first bag. I have, it's hot out here, and for that, you need a towel, which is instrumental in between points. Go and dry your hands, sort of get refocused. Wipe sweat off the brow like Fed. And I found this at a court, and I didn't even know that this was the official towel that they actually used, but I'm glad I kept it.
Ah, Perrier, a French bubbly drink, sponsor of the Roland Garros French Open. What does that say about me and the class that I have? This was given to me by my former employer. That's right, I used to sell this.
This is my visor. It's a Nike Heritage visor. I didn't realize that this was a court in the logo. And fun fact, this is also a woman's cap. I liked the floral pattern, so I got it. And it was definitely more feminine in person. So remember that when you're shopping on Tennis Warehouse.
I too fell for the female visor. I'm actually sporting it right now. I thought the coral would be much more muted, but it just screams woman. Can't say that I have an issue with that.
I always keep some hydration with me. For a session, we typically go about 2 hours. I need about four of these. I only have two today, so, and it's a scorcher, it's 100 degrees.
Alkaline water, long gone. I just refill this from the faucet. This is a liter and a half, and I'll usually pound that within the first hour.
My balls. I normally keep two brand new things of balls, and the last time I opened, we'll use these to warm up. Currently, I'm hitting Babolat Gold Championships. They're, according to the manufacturer, they're a 2-star for comfort, 3-star for responsiveness, and a 4-star for durability. They do last a couple sessions, so good balls.
I'm sporting the Wilson October version breast cancer awareness and the Dunlop ATP championship balls. I'm so stingy with these. These have been in there for at least 9 months and I'm not touching them.
Every time we play, he says, hey, you wanna use your balls?
They're pretty much decoration only, just to add some good weight to my bag.
Always got a couple extra balls just laying around. This is actually a pretty nice pen that I found at a court. I'll always scout out around the courts looking for balls people hit over that they don't wanna go and fetch. But you can get some good finds there.
The Nipple Monster helps with reflexes. Great for warm up. Can't go without it.
This is an octopus tripod. We strap this bad boy onto the fence to get some good court level shots or some aerial stuff.
Phenomenal YouTube channels don't happen by chance. They happen with quality products. And this is my camera bag, only the finest. $10 on Amazon.
I have sensitive skin, so I always keep some SPF protection with me. This is for heavy serious days like this one, and this is for when I'm working on my bronze, which isn't going well, folks.
SPF 70, also known as tattoo block, the best a man can get. I only put these on the ink that I have. Everything else can handle a burn because I don't really burn. I tan, baby, naturally. Thanks, Mom, for the Hispanic genes.
While my skin is white, the color white is also top-notch in tennis. There's nothing quite like a white hat, rocking with some white shorts and a white Henley. Still working on my full Wimbledon outfit. outfit, but I like to keep this for when the sun's getting in my way or if it's the right day for the outfit.
The white that I sport is a different accessory. This is not a legging. It's actually inspired by Dick Kyrgios. It's an arm sleeve, baby. Popularized in the NBA, now made its full way into the NFL, and finding a place in the tennis community, if I do say so myself. I look fresh to death. It does absolutely nothing for my performance. It's strictly for aesthetics.
I've got an ace bandage in here, in case I roll an ankle. But to be honest, this is so long.
Is that a blanket?
It's not gonna do me any good. It's so thick, I don't even know why I have this.
Is that a cloth robe?
A couple years back, I separated my shoulder in a soccer league. I got this for rehab, but now I use it for warm-ups because resistance is great for when you're warming up, the bounce on your muscles. I don't know, it's just, I saw one YouTube video that said resistance bounces are better than holding for warming up, but who knows.
When I was a kid, I was a jump rope king at recess. Those skills have translated to the tennis court. I use this for warm-up, baby.
My first racket, a Wilson Head TI Conquest. I got it for, I'm not kidding, $12 at Walmart. It's gone up in price, now it costs $20. 108 square inch head size. I'm just waiting for one day to have a really bad game and be fuming and to walk calmly over to the sidelines, reach into my bag, take out my racket. Caleb says, what are you doing? And I begin thrashing the ground and smashing this like Nick Kyrgios.
Regrettably, that day has already come for me. And this I carry around in case I wanna, as Ben said,
take out some frustration on the court.
Further on that temper tantrum from so long ago. Also, if somebody needs to borrow a racket, this is the first thing I offer.
Gamma Razor Tack Grip. This is what I've been using. It's high on the tack, very sticky. Doesn't play so well in the heat, but I like it so far. It'd be great for fall.
Another racket that I hold in this bag, the Head TIS7. Give it to me by a church friend. I think this sat in his attic for years upon years. Look at this monstrous head size, 120 square inches. Is this a helium balloon? It's just gonna carry away.
Yeah, wait.
I feel like Pennywise the Clown with this. It's very well baby for squash. So that's it here for that.
This is a list of drills that I wanted to try out. I drew little diagrams so I would remember what the heck I wrote down, because I can't read my own handwriting. We haven't gotten to this yet.
This is not a
word. Chapstick?
It is not lipstick either. This is stenciling for that beautiful Yonex logo that needs to be re-stenciled every time I hit.
This is literal Yonex ink. Is this like a trademark Yonex color?
Yes, I believe they put a patent on it. It's called red.
Got an extra string here, Technifiber Multi-Feel 16 gauge. I just like having one of these with me. I don't go to tournaments. I rarely need my racket restrung, but I like having stuff in my bag. So that's why I have it.
Well, the cat's out of the bag. You guys saw this just a second ago. The tool of my trade, the Yonex V-Core 95. We did a whole video on this, so I'll keep it short. But this is a wonderful stick endorsed by Dennis Shapovalov. Nothing but great things to say about it. Check out the video in the link.
My wrist sleeve. I wear it on my right wrist, like Fed, and I make sure the check is upside down.
Hold on.
Like Fed.
That looks mighty familiar. How do you explain that?
What? Dude, you're not supposed to turn that inside out on camera.
Same for the same pack, folks.
Yeah. He graciously gave me one.
This chump had nothing going for him. I said, stay in school and do it for him.
This is my first piece of tennis gear.
The light blue grip that doesn't slip, as you just said. This is the wet, tacky surface for my sweaty, sweaty hands. As I've mentioned before, my nickname in high school, the Oyster. Uncontrollable sweat.
This is a Head vibration damper, but I hate Head logo, so I keep it in my bag just to have a little knickknack. I'm never gonna put this on my racket.
Can I have it?
No.
I wanna put it on this one, but when I continue to smash it, it'll fly off and add it.
We'll see.
Talk later. I have an extra set of springs. These are the worst of the worst. Plasticky feel. I believe they're called synthetic. These were less than $5. I bought these just to complete the order and bump it over that $50 threshold for free shipping. This is my alpaca headband. It's Adidas. I swore to only buy Adidas stuff. Fresh Adidas kicks, Ubersonics 3. But one of his dumb rules is that once you pick a brand, you can't switch from it, so I'm stuck with it. It's longer than its Nike counterpart for alpaca, so it leaves like really long tails that look really stupid.
Oh, are you part of the Karate Kid crew?
Yeah, wax on, wax off, sensei.
Agni Kai.
I have my shoe bag in here, and actually my shoes are on my feet. The Nike Vapor Air Zoom X Plus Pro Spectacular. I forget how many names there are. Something along those lines. They're warm. I believe in the next video I'll be sporting some new kicks. Stay tuned.
Whoa.
Extra shirt, extra short. I'm wet as a whistle when I'm finished playing. And I have leather seats in my truck. I'm not trying to slide around while I drive home. Got some fresh pair of clothing to change it.
I'm running out of stuff to show you guys, but here we're on to the good stuff.
This was my first real racket that I got. It's the Wilson Ultra 97. Pretty good racket, served me well, but I upgraded. You know what I upgraded to, but
may I ask the reason for the upgrade? I mean, mine was smashed at smithereens. I had no choice but you.
I say it was because it was too small of a head size, but really, I just wanted to buy a new thing.
The Brick by Bose amplifies music to all parts of the court.
A tennis purist may say, no, you need absolute quiet and concentration, but once you play with music, there's no going back.
Exactly the thought I was going to share.
Fudge. The Wilson Clash, my new weapon of choice. Still learning the ways of this bad boy, but I love it so far. It's really forgiving, and I just have a blast playing with it. It was a great purchase. A little pricey, but very happy I pulled the trigger.
Last but not least, if I ever want a knockout between matches, I have my hammock here. I hit the trees, enjoy some shade, and get a little shut-eye.
We also bought this sick ball carrier, an absolute must for any tennis head.
Walmart, baby, less than $20. Gotta love Wally World. Every ball in that bag, basket, at least 3 months old. Dead as a doornail. Probably damaging to our arms and our overall game. Well, that concludes this edition of what's in our tennis bag. As you can see, we have well over 50 pounds of things. If we were flying, we would be fined by the airline. This is really just eye-opening.
This is consumerism.
We're materialistic
pricks. I look at this. This looks like my Christmas day. Like, I just unwrapped all my gifts and I'm looking at all my stuff.
Alright guys, subscribe, like, we'll see you on the next one.